Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. First want to apologize and say I wish that this video was longer, but if you can't tell and see how pale I look, I do not feel good. I feel lightheaded, I feel hot, but I'm not hot. I went to bed last night and I had this feeling like I wanted to throw up. I was able to go to bed last night after I took some medicine. And then this morning, I felt great. I felt completely fine until later on in the day when I was about to start recording. All of a sudden, I just got weak. I was tired. I was thrown up. I just felt sick again. I felt hot. It has been a struggle for me all day just to stand up and do things. So I'm sorry I didn't record. Now that Ryan is home, he's watching the baby, and I'm laying in bed finally recording for you guys. You're probably wondering what happened to the cat. When I was recording my morning routine video, all of a sudden I heard this big bang, like something fell. And at first I was like, probably nothing. The cats are always playing with each other. But then I was like, I don't hear their little bells, you know, because the cat's collars have a bell on it. And I was like, I don't hear it. So maybe they're hurt. So I ran into the laundry room. And I saw the power drill on the floor along with a couple of other things. And I was like, how did you knock a power drill off of the freaking shelf? One of the cats I could not find. And I looked over and I saw Malcom hiding in his cat tree. So I was like, what are you doing? Went to grab him and saw that he had this cut. When I saw it, I was like, oh my god, what happened? What did you do? What do I do? I called Ryan, told him, you need to come home. We need to take the cat to the hospital. I don't know what happened. I think that the power drill fell on him. I don't know. I'm not sure. Just come home. And then finally, Ryan came home and turned out we couldn't even go because there's like no emergency room for pets here. There's only a hospital that you would have to make an appointment for. Well, I took Ryan back to work and I took the car, and later on that day I took the cat along with Benji to the doctor's. I wish I had recorded a little bit at the doctor's, but they said I couldn't record inside the building, and I was inside the building for 2 hours before they finally called us back. Like maybe 20 minutes after that, they took the cat back and then they cleaned it out and they gave some staples and then put a cone on his head. And that was it, I came home. So far, it's been a little bit of a ride. Malcom has been like trying to rip the stitches out. He's been trying to take the cone off of his head. There's been a couple times where he got the cone off of his head and he was like biting at his arm. He did take one staple out. I noticed that this morning when I went down there, the cone wasn't on his head, and I looked at his paw and one staple is now missing. So I did put it back on his head, and I've been monitoring him very closely. And I guess I just wait and see if he can heal up pretty fast. I'm hoping he can. He is also on an antibiotic that he takes twice a day, and this is just to make sure that, you know, if he does find a way around the cone and licks it, it won't get infected. So yeah, other than that, he's a happy kitty. He's still running around playing, chasing everything, running into a lot of things, not noticing that he won't fit underneath it or through it at the moment. But yeah, everything is great right now. That's it for Malcom. I just wanted to let you guys know what was going on because of my last video. I'm sorry I don't feel well enough for you guys, but don't think I'm gonna leave you watching this video without looking at Mr. Benji. Of course not. Here is a video that I took last night of Benji trying to eat with a fork. It is the cutest stinking video ever. Take a look. guys. I love you, and I'll see you on Sunday. Bye.